Hello and welcome to the third episode on the Weekly Morning Show. I'm Jack, and here's what's happening this week. It has become clear that dogs are the preferred pet in Eastlime High School students. And this week, Kelly LaPlante checks in with a vlog with her dog.
This is my vlog, and I just woke up.
I am now about to finish my homework.
I am still doing my homework.
This is my dog, Eddie. Go. Play.
That's my vlog for the day.
With spring underway, we are reintroduced to our feathered friends that make waking up early in the morning a spiritual delight. As an editorial note, this only applies to about 4% of teenagers who are getting up before noon. Just a couple days ago, the governor shut down any lingering hope that school would reopen. And now the class of 2020 turns its attention to the state task force, who will determine how graduation will occur. When hearing the official news about the end of school, many from the class of 2020 gathered to memorialize the occasion in the parking lot. I wish somebody would have told me, babe, someday these will be the good old days. Thanks to Gabby Villa for capturing that moment. Next up is Gamer Talk with Evan Sleeper. For anyone who didn't see his Gamer Talks produced in school, you should know that he would include really cool animations. But getting the latest gaming news is probably more important than ever right now.
Hey guys, what's up? This is Evan Sleeper here, and we are back with another episode of Gamer Talk. We don't talk sports, we only talk games. For this episode, I'm going to talk about one of the most challenging games, Dark Souls 3. That game has been known to be like legendary difficult. But I managed to beat the game, and I'll tell you about the story. The character you play as is a warrior who was about to link a fire, but unfortunately failed and got burnt to ashes. The game takes place where he is silently revived to help put down the Lords of Cinder. The big reason why this game is difficult is because the bosses and the enemies attack multiple times in a row to keep you off guard. That's the reason why this game is sort of a challenge. But if you're lucky enough, you can maybe parry them and do a critical attack on them, or successfully block the attacks in order to survive. The main area of the game is called the Firelink Shrine. This is an area where bonfires are lit in order to, like, maybe link the flame. I know very little about it, though. But it's the main setting of the game. As you progress through the game, it gets harder each time, but there are armor and weapons out there that are pretty strong. You can reinforce them to make them stronger as ever and fight against the bosses and enemy hordes. I highly recommend the game to expert players who really love role-playing games and adventure games. Well, that's it for the gamer talk for today. Have a great day.
And in our final segment, Natalie Taylor gives us some more ideas for making the most of limited lives. And Ariel Vaglio has an awesome way to make a dish that is great any time of the day. The omelet.
L'espoir est un plat bien trop vite consommé. À sortir les repas, je suis habituée. Un voleur solitaire et triste à nourrir. Je suis amer, je ne peux réussir, car rien n'est gratuit. Dans la vie, je perds, on ne me dira.
That's all for this episode of the Weekly Morning Show. Before we go, have another look at the TikTok video sent to us from Olivia Catanzaro, made possible by the East Lyme First Student Drivers and the Flanders Fire Department. Who needs a drone when you have a ladder that big? I'm Jack, and we'll see you next week.